This is CHS TV News.
Good morning, Cathedral. I'm Keegan.
And I'm Brian. Good morning announcements for Tuesday, October the 3rd.
Let's start off the show with a message from Mr. Taylor.
Good morning, Cathedral. Happy Tuesday to everybody. I'm on the announcements this morning to talk about our bomb threat slash evacuation drill that's going to take shortly after announcements today during period one. I know Mr. Tribuco's got some slides for us to talk about this. So in an evacuation or bomb threat drill that we're going to do today, there is going to be an announcement made saying that an evacuation from the building is necessary. Today, a member of the admin team will go on the over the PA and say that this is a drill. However, we are going to evacuate the building. When this happens, we ask that all staff and students report out to the football field. Now, when you have to evacuate the building, you evacuate doing so using your fire exits, and you make your way to the field. Okay, so it's important to get out of the building as quickly as you can, but you are required to make your way out to the field. So again, that's exit through your fire exit, your primary fire exit from your location, and then you make your way to the field. For the purpose of today's drill, we have opened up the gates to the field, so you should be able to access it easily. Another thing that's different from a fire drill, with an evacuation drill or a bomb threat drill, you are required to bring all of your items that are with you in class out to the field. So that's binders, laptops, anything that you have on your person with you in your class is supposed to go with you out to the field for the evacuation. When you are out there, there is going to be designated spots for each grade, so it can be here on the screen. The main thing is you need to find your teacher while you're out there and stay in a group with your classroom. Okay, this is super important because in the event that we have to evacuate the building under a real threat, we meet and then we evacuate to one of our evacuation sites, which are a variety of different ones, including Wilma's Place, St. Patrick's, and potentially even Kathy Weaver Elementary School up the street if required. Those locations will be made known to you when the time is needed, but to the purpose of today's drill, we will be evacuating out to the field using the fire exits. And again, if Mr. Tribuco can just put up that slide one more time, just so everybody sees where you're going on the field, and that's where we're going to head today. So I appreciate and thank you all for your cooperation in this drill. I know it's been a few years since Cathedral has done one of these drills, but it's important given the state of what's been going on around the city of Hamilton. So thank you everyone for your attention. I'm going to pass it over to the student council.
Good morning, Gales. I'm Nicole.
And I'm Josiah.
With your council corner update. It's October, and that means Halloween will be here soon. We are excited to announce that our Halloween dance will take place on Wednesday, October 25th, here in our CAF. More information is coming soon, but save the date.
Moving on to Athletes of the Week, this week's male athlete of the week is Natneel Mulugeta. Natneel may be new to cross country, but he's already reaping the benefits of his hard work and training. Last week, in a competitive senior boys field, he placed 21st among some of the province's strongest runners. Natneel always puts forth his best effort and focus in practice, and we look forward to seeing what more he'll achieve at GHEC in a few weeks. Congrats, Natneel.
This week's Female Athlete of the Week is Lauren Daly. Lauren is a shining example of what it means to be a Gale. She has selfless attitude and unwavering commitment to the team's success. Lauren is the leading scorer on the junior girls basketball team. Congratulations to Lauren Daly on a great start to the season.
And in other sports-related news, this week, our Gales will be playing right here at CHS. Our senior boys volleyball team plays today at 4 p.m., and our junior boys play at 5:30 p.m. Tomorrow, our field hockey team has a game at 2 p.m. On Thursday, our senior girls basketball team plays at 3:30 p.m., and our junior girls play at 5 p.m. We wish all of our teams the best of luck, and we hope to see you cheering them on. That's it from me. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, guys. We here at CHS TV News are looking for new members. If you'd like to be sitting here reading the announcements or working behind the scenes to make our show happen, you should pick up an application form from room 103. Application forms are due tomorrow. We only take on new members once per year. See Mr. Tribuco in room 103 if you have any questions.
New members are also needed for the CHS media team. The CHS media team attends school events both during and after the school day to take photos and video clips. The images you capture will be used in the yearbook, on the school's social media channels, and in our year-end video. Application forms for the CHS media team are available outside of room 103 and are due by tomorrow. See Mr. Tribuco in room 103 if you have any questions.
The board game club is starting up again. If you enjoy playing board or card games, then you will want to join us every Wednesday after school in room 337 for friendly competitive play. For more information, attend the first meeting tomorrow at dismissal in room 337. Thank you from Mr. LaRocque.
This is a reminder to all those who made the first cut for the CHS Step Squad dance team. Your next practice is this Thursday after school in the green room. Please arrive by 3:10 p.m. sharp and dressed ready to practice. Thanks from Ms. Katz and Ms. Martyrs.
For all those who signed up for the Culture of Life Committee, you'll be meeting tomorrow after school in room 303. You will discuss your upcoming plans and activities. Thanks from Ms. Armachinsky and Ms. Marches.
There will be a wrestling workout session today after school. Please meet outside the phys ed office with appropriate workout attire. No wrestling experience is required. Thanks from Mr. Ryu.
All grade 9 girls are invited to participate in open gym for basketball this Friday morning at 7:30 a.m. Please sign up in room 216. Thanks from Ms. Pinto.
Speaking of
basketball, any grade 9 or 10 boys interested in playing junior boys basketball this year, please sign up in room 216. Open gym will begin on Tuesday morning at 7:15 a.m. Thanks from Ms. Pinto and Mr. Susie.
There's a senior boys volleyball game today at 4 p.m. against St. Mary in our gym. You'll be dismissed at 2:45 p.m. and your team photo will be taken before the game.
And lastly, all swimmers, please meet in room 206 at the end of the day for a brief meeting. Thanks from Coach Raftus. And to end off our show, I'll pass it over to members from CHS Lit.
Good morning, Gales. The long anticipated and one of the biggest events at Cathedral is back, where you can earn 10 Christian service hours. That's right, it's Halloween for Hunger.
We will have a table outside the cafeteria on both lunches to sign up or learn more about the event. If you're interested in volunteering during the night of Halloween to collect canned goods, handing out flyers before, or helping with the annex and party, then stop by tomorrow.
The annex is our donation and outreach building at Cathedral, and it needs your help stocking our shelves with items for the rest of the school year.
Last year, we raised over 10,000 pounds of food for those in our community. Please sign up with a group of four with a driver, or we will find you a group. And don't worry, sign-ups are for the next few weeks, so don't miss out your chance to spend your Halloween collecting something for others.
Thanks, Lit.
And those are all of your announcements for today, Cathedral.
Have a great day, Gales, and thanks for watching.